Hey, Erica here with API Video, and today I'm going to teach you guys about Chroma Subsampling. Chroma Subsampling is a technique that's used with YCbCr color spaces where you throw away some of the color data in your image or your video frame in order to compress the image more efficiently. And the general goal with this is to throw away color data in the image that's not going to be noticeable to the viewers and keep everything people notice. So typically, you might get rid of some of the chroma or color data, but you keep all of the luma or brightness data because the human eye actually sees brightness better than color. The way chroma subsampling works is really cool. Commonly, you'll have two rows of 4 pixels each, and that will be one block of pixels, and then you'll decide what happens to the color data in that block, and then you repeat it for every block. If we take a look at the diagram, I have 3 versions of chroma subsampling set up for you: 444, 422, and 420. So 444, you basically didn't throw away any data at all, right? You started off with your 2 rows of 4 pixels each, and you ended up with the exact same information. And this is really great if you are capturing video for the first time, because then you have as many options as possible later for what you want to drop out to optimize the images. And it's also great if you're going to be doing something like special effects or color work or anything where it's very detailed. This way you have the maximum amount of detail, and then when you're done later, you can decide what you want to drop out to compress. What the 444 notation is saying is that I'm going to have rows where each row has 4 pixels in it. That is this number here. And for the first row, which is going to be this one, let me write that right there for you guys. Well, you saw me write it and say first, so okay, that's kind of messy, but there you go. For the first row, you're going to take all of it and keep it exactly as is, because you're saying first row, take all 4 pixels and keep all 4 pixels. So, and ta-da, we kept it, and we kept it for all of them. All right, and so for the second one, same thing. We said in the second row, let's go ahead and keep all 4 pixels again. So we did that again, and so it's exactly the same. So you basically, you did not throw away any data, you didn't compress anything. This one and 420 are often used for, surprisingly, filming, actually. This one is probably a higher end camera where you're getting more data, and the 420 is probably like a webcam, or like your, you know, a camera on a phone or whatever. Like it could be either one of these though. So in this one, what we're saying is I have a block that's where it's 2 rows and it's 4 pixels in each row. So that's the first number again. And in the first one, I just want you to go through the 4 pixels and keep 2 of them. So we do that. We go keep one here and one here. So then the sample ends up being blue and red, and we lost the green and yellow. And then on the bottom one, it's pink and purple, and we lost the blue and orange. So this would be about, you know, what you would get. And then over here for the very last one, the same thing again. We're saying for each row of 4, go in and in the first row, take 2. So we said, okay, and I did. I just took this one and this one. And then the second one, we're saying, don't take any. So then you just copy the information again. So basically, you're only sampling 2 pixels out of the first row and nothing out of the rest of it, and that's how you end up with this. And surprisingly, in practice, you don't notice that this is what you're getting instead of something like this. You probably wouldn't notice it. It would just be slightly lower quality and be fine. And that's chroma subsampling. That's basically how it works. And you can change the blocks to be other sizes if you wanted, but this is a very common way of doing it. So we just went with that. And yeah, you will see it in YCbCr color spaces, and we'll go over what that is in another video. Thanks, guys. Talk to you later.